enjoy your full class assembly, otherwise known as a party party. We hope you enjoy it. In year four, we have been learning all about animals and wildlife found in and around ponds. Wait, ponds? Are ponds just a merry pool with a few tadpoles in?
No, ponds are aquatic ecosystems. They are in the water from the rivers, along with tidal currents and beaches.
So how do you know if a pond is a pond and not a lake?
Let me tell you, a pond can be defined as a body of water which can vary in size between 1 metre and 2 hectares, about 2.5 football pitches, which holds water for 4 months of the year only.
Ponds are part of our amazing landscape and have been around for hundreds of thousands of years.
Specific roads to the livestock markets. These were known as drainage ponds. They were used to water and wash the cattle.
Many were built as grand features of one house, and some with the roots on the whole house.
Ponds are amazing. They are hot spots of biodiversity and a wide habitat for thousands of species of wildlife.
But sadly, many ponds have disappeared over time and are being filled in and neglected.
This has resulted in wildlife decline, particularly with the flooding damage.
And there's even seven birds and birds. Why are those? Invertebrates are animals without a backbone, including the animals. How many invertebrates say is bound to part of hands, gaiters, water vapor, water snails, and water beetles?
And clinging to small vertebrates, animals with a backbone. Water and moist environment to survive. The species in this group include frogs, toads, and newts.
These amphibians can use oxygen by keeping their very thin skin.
So, ponds are so important for wildlife. What can we do to help keep them?
We can help by building more ponds.
We can look after the areas surrounding the pond and ensure that we don't drop any litter that could be thrown into ponds. A perfect example of this is of a pond in our school grounds. You might be asking yourself, what would you find in a pond? And what is it not only to read but show?
Let me introduce you to our pond superheroes. Listen to them as they tell you all about their pond and ponds.
Hello, I'm a pond superhero. I've got hairs on my feet by tracking them, allowing me to stand and move from the steps. I'm so light that I'm in the
Hello, I'm a whirligig beetle. I whirl across the surface of the water. Half of my eyes can see above the water and the other half can see below.
This is so I can always be looking out for predators or prey.
Hello! I am a heron and I love to stop by ponds for food.
I'm a swallow. I sweep over the water for a tasty bug and skim the pond for first quenching drink.
I'm your trusty fox with a big five times my height to catch by the Olympian. And I also lay it to up to 4,050 eggs in front.
Many,
and I am your graceful dragonfly. My eyes are so big you can see all the way around us, and 300 million years ago you were the size of seagulls.
Darkness slowly crept in from the point. The ominous silence was broken by the soft croaking of the lazy dog. A hedgehog shuffled in the human darkness. A bird called. A loud splash echoed around as a spotted leech rolled off a lush lily pad into the dingy water. A meal happily frolicked into the peaceful forest as a neighbor and resistance.
Please join us as we sing our Love Connection song. If you know it, join us.
To connect the explored Claude Monet. Monet was a famous artist known for his style of painting, Impressions.
Impressionists did not want to paint a realistic picture, but an impression of what they saw.
They used thick layers of paint and fast brush strokes to capture and captured the same picture in different seasons and lights.
Van Gogh painted a picture based on Monet's watercolours.
In our prayer. Dear God, thank you for creating our beautiful world filled with incredible animals and wonderful wildlife. We pray that everyone understands the importance of looking after our world and respect all that live in it. Amen.